multitude of all the superstar athletes. How did you team up with your coach? Is he the coach of the national team?
Yeah, he's no, it's not the national team. It's our program on
your boxing gym
in Wingate. Yeah.
Okay, what's his name?
Paul Richard.
What's his background in boxing?
He used to train in Mayweather gym.
Oh really?
Yeah.
And now he's training you guys. Do you guys like it? Good boxer.
Yeah, he teach us a lot.
Nice guy.
Yeah.
How is boxing in Israel though? Is it advanced, developed, or a little bit?
Before him?
Yeah.
Like now it's getting very big improvement.
Coach, how do you like the boxing program in Israel? You're helping to improve it. You're helping to elevate it.
It needs a lot of help. It needs more interest from the public, which we're getting. The ministry's helping out well. And the Ministry of Sport's helping out. It's tough.
But they're working very hard. They love it.
They got a lot of heart in Israel.
Yeah.
Big.
And that helps in this sport. You need balls in this sport.
Yeah.
You need brains and balls.
Yeah.
What's your background? I know you coached a mate with this gym.
Good team. Thank you so much.
Thank you. I'm a coach from the UK for the last 20 years.
What city?
St. Albans,
okay.
London, and home counties.
I was just there last week for Amir's fight. I was in Boston and in Birmingham.
But I've been coming over here for 20 years.
Wow.
With Uncle Roger, Floyd's uncle.
Yeah, of course.
He taught me about everything.
So is the next Mayweather coming out of Israel?
This little fella here.
Yeah.
He can move and box a bit, you know?
Yeah.
He's quick.
He's always smiling.
He can move and box. You didn't get it today. You didn't see it, but he can box. The other guy's fight. I mean, he wants to fight.
He's a Mexican style.
Tied him up a bit. He's quick and strong, but we've got to take the stiffness out of him a bit so he relaxes.
He moves a lot. I know he's going to get tired with it.
Yeah, this guy's picked it up in the last 3 months. This is starting to work for him.
So how does a gentleman like yourself end up in Israel? How did that even happen?
In Israel, I was looking to come here. So I called somebody I knew in Israel, and he said to me, well, why don't you come here?
Check it out.
And see what we got going on here. And I went there 15 years ago. But it was a different scene back then. So I went and had a look and see their nationals. Pretty decent. But then after I moved there, I realized that they need more people coming. I had these guys over. I had USA over.
Raheem.
What's up, baby?
You on TV?
I'm good. How did you like Israel? You hung out with them for a little bit.
I was good. I had a fight in over there.
And what happened in the fight?
Man, he just keeps coming forward and forward. He just keeps going.
He does. He's like Energizer Bunny.
Yeah. How you been?
Good. I just got here. Good to see you.
How you doing?
So you guys hosted them in Israel?
Yeah. So I take them to the UK every 2 months, 3 months as well. I think now we've got so much work. In the last 3 weeks here, they must have had 36, 37 rounds of sparring.
What are their chances of making it to Japan 2020? Is that the goal right now, short term?
It's tough on the European circuit because Europe's really tough.
Yep.
You've got Ukraine, you've got Russia, you've got England,
France,
GB, France, all of them.
Bulgaria, Hungary. Boxing is very developed in a lot of those countries.
And they're investing in them countries.
Yep. So you need to be something special, because in the past some Israelis have made it to the Olympics.
Yeah, with a different selection process.
Yeah.
See?
Okay.
Now they got if he does what he did last year, it should be good. So you're dealing with a lot of boxers that are 28, 29, 30, 32. So when you're 20 years old like Mikhail,
yeah,
strength and experience. I mean, he's come up from 52 kilograms, Mikhail, to 75 in like 2 or 3 years. So he hasn't carried the strength through with it.
Well, good luck. Hopefully it goes well. Point, just in general, it's very interesting for people who are going to watch this video. They're not going to realize that, let's say, Mikhail is Jewish. Where did Ahmed go?
Arab.
Shara. Muslim. And they're both on the same team. They're like brothers. They train together. They stay in the same rooms. They all get along because of boxing. Tell me how boxing brings people together.
We kick politics out of the gym.
So if you have a political opinion, leave it outside the door.
Plus, also, they learn respect for each other. Once they box each other and spar each other. So they learn respect rather than distance from each other and talk. They're up close and personal with boxing. So, it takes a little bit of time, but after a while, they learn to respect.
What's your name?
Bashara.
How do you like being on the same team with Mikhail, with the coach, with everybody?
It's very okay for me. Peace. We're training each other. We are friends.
Yeah. Who's your favorite boxer?
Ever. Now?
In history.
In history? Floyd Mayweather.
And now also?
GGG.
GG, who do you like the most?
Lomachenko.
Lomachenko? Everybody loves Lomachenko.
There's a lot of Russian background in Israel.
Terence or Lomachenko.
Terence or Lomachenko. Okay.
Lomachenko's a man though.
Lomachenko's amazing. Yeah. He's been to Israel.
Yeah. Yeah, we've been
he
in Ukraine.
He told me he had his hand surgery in Israel.
I was in Ukraine.
I've been in Ukraine.
We were in Ukraine.
They love boxing in the Ukraine. You guys can
pass.
Oh,
it's big out there. And it's good. Yeah, it's a good, great city.
It's good stuff. All right. So, if people watching, what's your message to everybody watching, Coach?
Support boxing, especially amateur boxing, especially in the US. I think they need a lot of help here. It used to be one of the greatest sports here, and it needs all the help you can get.
By the way, are people surprised when you say I'm Muslim but I fight for Israel? Is it surprising to people?
Yeah.
And what did they tell you? Confused?
Yeah.
And you're like, hey, it's my country.
Yeah, yeah. They said, how you box and for country that you are already from.
Yeah.
I said, it's okay for me. I go. I'm improving in boxing. They said, how are you improving this boxing country? You box for this country.
Yeah.
I said, it's okay for me. We are improving.
You have friends now?
And yeah.
You caught me on a sideshow podcast as well. I'm about to go get my hair done.
Yeah.
So I don't need.
Don't worry about it. All right, if there's one professional fighter you want to fight, who is it? One professional. Who do you want to fight?
One professional fighter?
You.
I don't know.
Canelo, Triple G?
I want to be the best by myself at first.
Alright, thank you, gentlemen.
To win the Olympics.
Alright, hopefully good luck. Thank you, coach. Tell everybody your name.
Paul Richards.
Paul Richards, the Alpha, doing big things. Please report that come back recording. And your shirt says, I stand with Israel. What do people say when they see the shirt?
In the US, I get a lot of support. I haven't worn it back in Israel yet.
They love it too.
So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Elie Seckbach.